We have come to the end of prepared speeches section. Now comes the table topic section. To run the table topic session for today, we have Toastmaster Azhar. He loves to hear stories from people, especially when you are sad, because that is when your true emotions come out. For all you eavesdroppers, he has a tip. At your workplace, if you have to eavesdrop, please wear earphones. With a thunderous applause, let's welcome Toastmaster.
Small correction in the tip that was given by Vinod. It's not to avoid the eavesdrop that you get, but it's to know who is eavesdropping behind you. You don't play music, you just have your earphones and see what people talk about you, whether they talk good or bad. Okay. So it's been 3 months since I have been a Toastmaster, and the most common thing that I have seen in this Toastmaster is whenever the TMOD calls for the TD master of the day, suddenly people get thirsty. They walk out of the room. Or suddenly someone gets a phone call, or somebody looks for an important message in their phone. So, with this, a very good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome guests. For the benefit of guests, let me tell you what table topics is. I'll be giving a topic for which random speakers from the crowd will come to the stage and they will talk for 2 minutes. If they are talking below 1 minute, they will be disqualified for the voting. And an extra 30 seconds will be given for each and every speaker to wrap up their speeches. So I welcome you all for this exciting and scary session of any Toastmasters meeting. Are you excited?
Yes.
Okay, let's get started. The first speaker for today is Toastmaster Mohan. Okay. The topic for you is, you don't like to eavesdrop, but the voice is so sweet that it attracts you to eavesdrop. You don't like to eavesdrop, but the voice is so sweet that it attracts you to eavesdrop.
Toastmaster. If Vinod asked me who all eavesdrop, very few hands went up. So either you eavesdrop or lie. So we all love to eavesdrop. You don't want to be known as the eavesdropper. That's the thing. So when the voice is sweet, I take it as listening gossip to somebody else. So you don't want to do it directly. So obviously you love to hear, hey Thomas, what happened? Or what happened? Could you tell me more what happened in emergence? So we all want to know everything what goes on. Want to be today, especially want to be hyper-connected. We not only want to be known in person, like some of the oldies in the group will be on social media. Today everything is so hyper-connected. It's so amazingly, you know, hyper-connected. So basically, we want to eavesdrop, but my take is we don't want to be known as eavesdropper because it gives a bad connotation to the whole thing. So we really want a set of eavesdroppers around us who will always feed in the information. The voice of those eavesdroppers is so sweet, you definitely want to listen to what's happening around you through them.
Hard time to get topics related to this eavesdrop. It was so different and unique. I was really going mad to get the topics. So our next speaker is Toastmaster Thomas. Your topic is funniest washroom talks you have washroom talks you have ever heard.
Thank you, TD Master. Good afternoon, my fellow Toastmasters and guests. More than funniest, the most memorable eavesdropping I ever did was turned out to be
espionage for my company. Now there is, I can justify the funny part because in the washroom, conversation is funny. So please take that as my contribution to the funny part. What happened was, three guys from Tata Motors were seated in the Calcutta airport behind me. When two or three people start talking, they work in their own world. They forget the rest of the world. They didn't know me. Here I was pretending to read the Economic Times or some yellow paper. So serious, absorbed. These guys were discussing their regional launch plan for Eastern region. And it's like getting the board papers, right? I collected all that, by the way, to justify, and truly, I met them in the washroom. So that ties me with the topic. And I was a hero when I went back to my company and shared these details. I didn't feel guilty, I felt like a hero. So there's one instance because of which I could not have to confess. I didn't have to confess about very many other embarrassing instances of eavesdropping with that gentleman alive. So this turned out to be a respectable, courageous, admirable, reward-worthy eavesdropping. Thank you.
Actually, this has happened to every married man. Of course, it's happened to me also. Actually, I was talking to my friend. My wife was not there. I was talking to my friend saying that my wife is not supporting me in the food, what taste I want. When I ask chicken, he will do sambar. When I ask sambar, he will do rasam. But he says always, yes, I did sambar only. But sambar is like rasam. So I said, this is what is going to happen in my life. So let us book one room and we enjoy. That is what I discussed. So by the time my wife will enter and see, he's dropped. He got all the message that what I discussed with my friend, where you want to go. Then I told, see, actually in the life, no, we want to always want to achieve something, take a food and see, this fellow is giving a green signal again. So I really forgot the topic. See, this is what the eavesdropping problem. Eavesdropping, if you go and eavesdrop somebody, you forget yourself. Really, we have all the problem. We have a lot of problems. We have don't employ, we don't have a currency, demarcation, everything. Still, we want to know Jared Gaur, how he did. So, this is a record or what? Really, not record. But we are habituated. We are habituated at the same time, the same thing. So, see, actually, what we are doing is we will hear it and then again we come to the front and then say that this is very good, I love it, everything will say. But of course, if you put your hand in your consciences and say that anybody in this room not having eavesdropping, I say no. Everybody is having eavesdropping. They want to hear something about anything. That's what the grace is. Thank you very much.
Our next speaker will be Sunil. Having a conversation in a park and you realize someone is overhearing you or eavesdropping you, how do you continue it? You and your wife are having a conversation in a park and you realize someone is overhearing you, how do you continue it?
Thank you. Somebody is eavesdropping here now. I did not hear this. It all depends on the subject. If you are sitting and discussing about children, and suddenly some young ladies passed by. Stop talking about children. And one day we were talking in the park about some crap, about some movie or something. Suddenly I noticed one postmaster walking near me. So he was looking at me till that moment. He was looking at me like a very respected and senior postmaster. Suddenly I shifted my topic to the international. Postmaster president election and the number of clubs, and my wife was looking at me like, what club you are talking about? So it all depends on the topic. So I'm very good at twisting my subject if I'm talking to my wife. The one ability which I have developed after marrying my wife, who is my current wife. That to listen to this ear and this ear and do whatever you like. So I have the capacity of multitasking. So to think about something else and listen to your wife. In the same way, I have the capacity also to discuss something and to adapt to your circumstances and change the topic. Learn it. If you have any doubt, please approach me.
So my next speaker is Toastmaster Shah.
We got it.
The topic is, even walls have ears.
Yeah.
Your experience or comments about it. Even walls have ears.
Even walls have ears. I happened to be in the restroom once. I don't want to explain like what I mean. There were other two guys in my project, but I was not seen by them. What happened was, they were actually bashing my boss verbally. It was the most awful language I have ever heard. And I know that it was real because he was also my boss. We were sharing the same boss. This happened. And I just went to my desk and I started searching like what conversation, I mean, what is this conversation called in a dictionary? So I just started searching, and we have one professor called Google, so I just searched. This conversation which I overheard, eavesdrop in the restroom, is called Latrino. Latrino is nothing but the conversation which we have in the latrino. So this was the most memorable and the awful conversation I've ever had. Thanks. Our next speaker is Vijay. Your topic is privacy is a myth. Privacy is a myth. Vijay.
Good evening, Toastmaster sir. Welcome, guest. Yes, sir. Privacy is a myth. Reason being, privacy is not. There is no privacy, even that. For example, said that in the restroom, there is no privacy. Even in the restroom, we don't have privacy. So that's how the world is going on. And even in social media, also, we don't have privacy. Even if you like something and post something, the post which you do, if your boss doesn't like, that will affect your career. So that way, nothing is secure here. even though I work in IT, nothing is privacy. Thank you.
Our next speaker is Amit. Your topic is eavesdropping is good and healthy. Justify. Eavesdropping is good and healthy. Justify.
I heard two friends. They were just discussing that they are planning a party tonight in their room. I was about to open the door and ask them, "Hey guys, I am here." But when I heard this, I stopped. And I started eavesdropping what these guys were talking. My friend Rohan, he just said to Shyam, "Hey Shyam, come on, leave Amit. He is a very foodie guy. Even I am not look like that. But leave Amit. We are going to have a party tonight." I thought, what these people are discussing? They are just leaving me behind and they will just have fun. And I let them plan. I just left the place from there. Exactly at 9 PM, again, I switched the doorbell. They thought Rohan came and opened the door. He was amazed to see me. That this guy, we didn't inform him and he's here now. Now we are not going to have our fabulous chicken biryani. So I went there and I have the party with them. And it was a very good party that night. So eavesdropping is sometimes healthy and good. Over to you.
Our next speaker is Akintya. The topic is you eavesdropped a medley XCOM meeting. What did you hear? The topic is you eavesdropped a medley XCOM meeting. What did you hear?
Well, it's just been, it's barely a month since I just gone to the XCOM, but yes, for a very long time there's been this discussion about an XCOM party or something that I've been, I don't know where the rumor started, but that's something I'm really looking forward to because it's a promise that they made, and it's party. So imagine the only thing that flashes into my mind is food. Food and probably outing with the gang. So that's the only thing I've heard so far. And apart from that, I haven't heard anything else. So yeah, that's it.
I didn't have any guests. I'm only here. I shouldn't have eavesdropped, but sometimes that's the only way to find the truth. I shouldn't have eavesdropped, but sometimes that's the only way to find out the truth.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests.
Good evening.
We have 2 years and only one more. In our day-to-day life, we cross many people, strangers and known people. It's a known fact that we cannot avoid the people who is passing nearby and around us. Even though we do not want to hear what others are speaking about their social life, economic life, religious life, etc. But we are in a situation, crunch situation, to hear what they are going to say about a particular topic. Say for example, I may be passionate about cricket, but the other person who is nearby may not be passionate about cricket. I had a good conversation with my friend in a train, talking about the success of Sachin Tendulkar 100th century. But the person who is nearby is not interested about the cricket, and he's not passionate about that. But we are having a good conversation, but on the other hand, he is not at all interested. But he is in such a condition, he was forced to hear what we are having a conversation. This is only a small example I'm telling, where the person who is hearing is not a passionate about particular game or sports. Similarly, in office and in our personal life, we are in a situation, even though we are not interested to hear certain talk, it's the truth, the fact that we are in a situation to hear it forcefully. Okay.
Something bad about you while eavesdropping. What would be your reaction? You hear something bad about you while eavesdropping. What would be your reaction?
Thank you. Let me talk about the eavesdropping. Today, my personal experience in the bank. I don't care about my criticism. Even critics will help you to grow up to the ladder. Morning, I want to withdraw cash from my mother's pension account. I used to do it. After demonetization, November 8th, I never used to do that because I used to give whatever she needs. She told me that so long you never took any money. I went to the bank and I spoke to the IOB. Before that, I dropped to Mr. Ramakrishnan. He wanted a lift also. And he said that, please drop me near IOB. Then I went inside. I spoke to the counter cashier. He told me that, sir, there is no cash, only 10,000. It's eavesdrop, according to me. I went to the manager and I spoke to the manager. I said, for the 5 months I never paid off, this is a pension amount, nothing secret. Immediately he acknowledged and I applied for 24,000. I went to the teller counter. The second eavesdrop there, daughter-in-law and mother-in-law is there. Mother-in-law's husband was no more. He was working in the electricity board as a chief engineer. A pension, it comes around nearly 3 months. 90,000 rupees something else is there. Daughter-in-law is insisting her to get a debit card. She left to get an application form to apply for a debit card. I told her, this is my, I overheard that, what she was talking to her mother-in-law. Don't get a debit card at this age, 73 years of age. If you insert a debit card, suppose you will forget about the password, somebody will take your money. Better idea is, add your cell number in your account. Whatever withdraw, deposits, you will come to know that. This is the second eavesdrop. The third eavesdrop, since I am a positive person, I withdrew the money of 24,000 rupees. The last 2,000, I told the teller, just give me 20s. She gave me 420s. The man behind me, he is also very old, 75. And he was saying that I got from the counter 2,000 rupees. I don't need change. I need a change. Immediately I gave it. But how I am converting all these eavesdrops in a positive attitude because of my positive attitude. Thank you.
With that, we come to the end of our session. We hope you enjoyed the session. We had a wonderful speech about PT from education speaker Girish Mohan. Hope we incorporate those insights and tips in the upcoming IIC competition and in our table topics session as well. Okay, with that, I hand over the podium to TMO.